Hi everyone, and welcome back. My name is Kiki Simpson, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create collections in Azure Active Directory. First, let's talk about what collections are. A collection is a filter on the apps users already have access to, meaning collections themselves are not tied to app access. Collections are simply a UI construct used to customize our end-user app portals, such as My Apps and the App Gallery on Office.com. For example, on my apps, in all apps, I have this long list of all the applications I have access to. I then have this tab called Contoso, where I see all of the Contoso HR tools that I have access to. If I then go to office.com in the gallery view, I can scroll and see the same collections that I just saw on my apps. So regardless of which portal you and your users prefer, collections are important for your tenant. So let's dive into creating them. To manage all of your collections in your tenant, you'll first navigate to the Azure portal at portal.azure.com. From there, you'll scroll down and go to Azure Active Directory, Enterprise Apps, and then Collections. You'll need to have a P1 or P2 Azure license to create these collections in your tenant. If you're a global admin, an app admin, or a cloud app admin, you'll see all of the collections in your tenant. Anyone else that visits this page will only see the collections that they're owners of, but I'll get into that in a minute. To create a new collection, hit the button New Collection. From here, you can give it a name and description. Let's go ahead and create a copy of the Contoso collection you saw earlier. We'll name it Contoso 2.0 and put in the description that this is just a test and that we'll delete it later. Next up, let's put the apps that we want in this collection. Clicking Add App, you can then search for and select all the apps you want to include. Let's see, we'll need Contoso Hub, Benefits, Expense, Support, and then Careers. Click Add once you've added all of them, and then using the arrows or clicking and dragging, you can set the order the apps appear in. If you want to highlight certain apps, try putting them at the top of this list. From there, you can then go on to add users or groups that you want to be able to manage this collection. This is the owners that I was talking about earlier. Owners will be able to edit any of the attributes of a collection. However, only global admins, app admins, and cloud app admins have the power to create new collections or delete existing ones. I'll add myself here, even though this user is already a global admin. Next, we'll go ahead and add users and groups that you want to have access to this collection. Ownership and access are different. Owners have editing abilities, and then access will be the people that see it in their end user portals. Remember, giving an access to a collection doesn't give them access to any of the apps within it. The user will just see it as it appears as an app filter. I want to make sure that I'm the only one to see this collection to make sure it's right, so I'll add myself here. After adding users, you can go on to the review and create stage. Here, we show you all of the details of the collection you just created. If you're just setting up a collection for owners to then manage, this page will be a little empty. But if you really set one up, it'll look like this. To learn more about collections and how to create them, go to aka.ms/myappsdocs. Thanks so much for watching our videos.